Hey, welcome to my Let's Play of Little Hope. It is a blind playthrough, I've not played it before. It's my first proper Let's Play as well. So if there's anything that you'd like me to do differently or like to see different next time, leave some comments down below. Please don't forget to hit the like and subscribe. I should be pushing two videos a week. One will be Sunday, one will be Wednesday. And it'll be Little Hope until we finish that. And then if anyone's got suggestions on what we play next, please let me know. Don't forget you can catch my Twitch stream late at night, 10 p.m. UK time. And that's every day other than Wednesdays. Cheers, guys. Enjoy the playthrough. Welcome to the Dark Pictures, Little Hope, with Sharky77X. We're going to be playing Little Hope through for the first time. It's going to be our first Let's Play. Try not to get everybody killed. Get started.
Thanks for pulling over.
Sure. Something wrong?
We got a problem up ahead. A big accident. We've had to close the road.
You're right.
We're diverting all traffic through Little Hope. You okay, buddy? You seem a little confused.
Yeah, I'm fine. I just want to get these folks to where they need to be.
I doubt a short delay will trouble them too much. Head up the East Road. Takes you straight through Little Hope. Adds almost no time to your journey.
Looks like we have our destination. Off to Little Hope.
Chip any harder, it'll wear away to nothing.
Right.
How long have you been sober?
A few days shy of 3 months.
Impressive. I heard the first 90 days are the toughest and roughest.
I know it doesn't add up, but I get something from holding on to this.
We're going the wrong way.
It's fine, just a quick detour.
It's not fine.
Calm down. It's all okay.
Oh, please, John, could you not patronize me?
Can you keep it down, please?
A girl stood in the road, caused the bus driver to lose control and crash the bus. Is that our first? Have we seen our first ghost? Is that what this is? I think the bus crash was obvious, right? Let's see where it goes. This is our bearing. So I don't know. We can affect it slightly by navigating. But obviously our bearing is east right now. Okay, so we've got quite a few bearings. There's a lot of secrets. I guess we can unlock them further along we go. And some pictures. Okay, we'll keep an eye out for them. Big house.
Stop it, James. You know I hate it when you don't take the things I say seriously.
Come on, sweetheart, I do. I just had a rough day today.
Can you believe they are at each other again? I can.
You're drunk. What a surprise.
I just caught the game with the guys, honey. That's it.
That's not it. Never is.
There's talk. Some of us may be losing our jobs. The factory...
You've been saying that for years. I'm more worried about Megan.
What's wrong with Megan? She looks okay to me.
Everything looks okay after 10 beers. Reverend Carson held her back after prayers today. That's 4 weeks running. She's not right. It's serious, James.
You worry too much about that kid. I can't deal with this right now.
Another surprise. You can't deal with anything. When would be the right time?
You're making a mountain out of a molehill. Getting yourself worked up for nothing.
For nothing? Single-handedly keeping our family together
family.
Is far from nothing in my book. I could use a little help.
Maybe if we'd had kids of our own, none of this would be happening.
That's a real low blow. Don't you get how tough this is?
You're not the only one feels pressure. The factory situation is serious, Anne. Real serious. Not right now.
What angry man.
Not tonight. No way.
There's the Clark Tanya's family late. Home in Massachusetts.
She always okay. is these days.
Do we give her a break? Being different? She's always been late. We say nothing. Maybe... We'll be indifferent for the moment then, yeah?
Tanya has always been late.
Nah, not really. Only since she's been seeing him. That guy's no good for her. All that new age bullshit. Reminds me of some creepy cult.
He came in last week. We shot the breeze a little bit. I like him.
That one's a classic. Legendary vinyl. Quit pawing at it, will you? Hey, Bigfoot, mind the goddamn vinyl, will you?
Indignant. Don't be a dick. Do we? I mean, it was. Was it an accident? It wasn't really, was it?
Come on, man. Take some time off from being a dick and give her a break.
Okay, Mother Superior. Why are you always sticking up for her anyway?
Oh, here she is.
I'm going to start climbing through the window unless that door gets fixed. How's things? Let me guess. He's been pumping iron again?
They've been at each other's throats since Dad got home.
What's it about this time?
Some dad we got. Yeah, some dad we got.
Nearly fell through the front door. Some dad we got, huh?
They're always fighting these days, getting predictable, like a record that keeps playing over and over.
Dennis, for the 10 millionth time, will you shift that shit of yours up into the attic?
Some respect. This is a valuable, rare, and sought-after collection. I think she was a Marine sergeant of past life.
What's crawled up his ass?
Why is everybody so angry in this? Dennis being Dennis.
Just Dennis doing what he's good at. Being really Dennis.
What a surprise.
Hey, Dennis. Hey!
Not now, sis. I'm busy. Hey! Quit acting crazy!
Sweetheart,
I heard you talking about me.
Not now, Megan. I'd like to have a bath in peace. Take a break from this madhouse for a while.
She's the creepy one, then. Keep an eye on this little girl. I bet she's going to be absolute mischief.
Maybe you should talk to Mom and Dad.
It's not a great idea for me to get involved. You know what I'm like? I just upset someone.
This sounded more serious than the usual bullshit. They were talking about Megan. She's done something bad.
I can't say I'm surprised. There's definitely something off with Megan.
I don't get why everyone keeps picking on her.
Okay, Mr. Shining Knight in Armor. Where's the little princess anyway?
She'll be concerned. She's a bit of a weird girl, right? Aggressive. Good check on that. Let's be concerned.
Probably better to leave Megan alone.
As her big sister, it is my sworn legal duty to check in on her.
Right, sure. Like you're the law around here. She went upstairs.
I'll go find her.
Press and hold R2 to pick up objects, and we can use R to examine them. Some interactions reveal secrets, and secrets you find can be viewed in the collections and character screen. Okay, so we have to pick it up first, and then we can interact. Some matches. Okay, it doesn't look like there's anything really to do with it, so I guess we'll shake. Oh no, press X in time for heartbeat. But I made change to keep. Right, okay.
To keep an eye on your little sister. Mom is real worried about her.
Sarcasm. I guess I'm English. It's the English way.
Can't imagine why. Growing up with such a great and supportive family.
You want to try raising a family like this? The devil himself would struggle with you guys.
He'd probably try, though. Okay, so we use the left stick to move. We're going to check on Tanya. I think it's through there, is it? Got that.
Son of a bitch, clock.
scared him, didn't it? I don't know where we're supposed to go. Upstairs, maybe? We do anything with the clock. Nope.
Up. Hey, Tanya. You up there? How's Megan doing?
Don't know. Haven't seen her yet.
Keep it down, will ya? Trying to sleep here.
Now you've done it. Sleeping Beauty wakes.
Forget him. Find Megan.
Relax. I'm on it.
Do me a favor. Quit yelling for a couple of minutes. House could use some quiet.
Yeah, we're gonna go with the sarcasm. Oh, should we be polite? Kind of feel like that could be a good move here.
Sure, no problem. Not another sound.
Place is crazy enough without your 2 cents. It's all the noise about, anyway.
Just checking in with Tanya and Megan.
Good luck with that. Megan's a handful.
What a man. What a man. What are we supposed to do now, then? We gotta go find Megan? I thought we turned the TV off, did we not? Maybe just mute it. Okay. Maybe outside. Okie dokie. Not going that way then. Oh, okay, that's not the route. What we found here. Megan Clark is a pupil. Number of days present. 30, 29, 27, 30, 29, 28, 173 days absent. 1, 3, 1, 2. They're all 30 days then, are they? Days tardy? Okay. Interesting. We got the back there. 6 week periods. Is she getting C's and D's in English? Her reading's not bad. She's got a couple of B's. History, she's failing bad. She really is not doing well, is she? She's like below in the 70s, below 70s. Okay. Alright.
Anthony, where are you, goddammit? Anthony, I'm getting really pissed off! Anthony, I swear if you don't answer me!
Oh no.
You could be right about my family. I think so too.
Tanya, what's going on?
That little brat locked me out! It's fucking freezing!
Oh no. Oh no.
I'll let you back in. Go easy on Megan. Hold on.
Oh no. Uh-oh.
Shit! Megan! You in there?
That's not good. That is not good. Get everyone out.
The kitchen's on fire!
Are you fucking serious?
Cal's still boarding.
Megan! Man.
Hey, Dad. Maybe we can save you.
Mom! Where the hell is everybody?
Why is no one going to the door?
Help!
Balcony!
Anthony, help!
should we do? Can we help anybody?
Tanya. Oh my God.
Help! What should I do?
I had no choice. Down the drain pipe.
Get to the drain pipe and climb down.
Won't you spare me over till another
try not getting him killed. Already killed an entire family. I feel like that's not my fault though. You guys can't hold me accountable for that. Blame doesn't sit on my shoulders, I'm sure of that. That sets the tone for the rest of this game. The future looks bleak.
Hello. And welcome. I don't believe that we've met before, have we? No matter. Welcome to my repository. I am the curator, the guardian of all these wonderful stories. And I have a very special tale for you to tell.
Cool is.
Disconcerting, no? I'm sure there's nothing to worry about. This particular story isn't fully fleshed out. It's only part written, and the choices you make will complete it. The fire, no, there was nothing you could have done about that. What's happened has happened. Or has it? Anyway, look to the future, I say. Life's but a walking shadow, eh? You are about to enter a confusing, perhaps disturbing world. How disturbing might depend on what you choose to believe, and how confusing on the path you choose to take. There are an infinite number of directions in which one could travel. We seldom have all the information that we'd like, but we have to choose our path nonetheless and hope that we get the clarity and the outcomes that we want. As in life, your decisions will matter. The choices you make will affect others. You've seen how the story starts. So much death. How many more deaths is entirely up to you. It depends on the decisions that you make. What are you? Rational? Emotional? Do you trust your head or your heart? There is no right answer. Sometimes one is best and sometimes the other. My advice, for what it's worth, is to thine own self. Be true. But I'm here simply to record what you do, not to help you. I'm not supposed to interfere, you see. Not my place, apparently. But I am apparently allowed to share wise words from great storytellers that have gone before, where I feel that that would be appropriate. Oh, one final thing before I let you go. There are pictures in Little Hope that will, if found, show you a vision of a possible future, something that may or may not happen. Use them. They might help you. You have a funeral to attend.
Okay.
Off you go. Have fun. I do enjoy a good funeral.
None of us here today can understand why this tragic accident happened. But we can take comfort from the knowledge that the family are together for eternity in God's loving embrace.
That was the dude that drove Tanya there, right? Gonna guess that's her boyfriend then. Andrew, 18, college student. Taylor, 22, also a college student. John, 43, who's a college professor.
Where the hell's Daniel? I can't find him.
I don't know.
Aha, this
Instead
is the bus.
Instead of goofing around, you want to lend a hand here?
How is he doing anyway?
It doesn't look that serious. Could be concussed.
Okay, professor.
Changes to character relationships can be seen in collections and character screen.
Why don't you...
Oh, wow, okay, so when we do that, it just interrupts it. Fine. Aha. Right. We can select Taylor assisted John with check on Andrew after the bus crash. Okay. Fine. Current objective is to try to call for help. Now, this is the Baron's secrets and the pictures. We haven't found any pictures yet, but that's fine. So, Taylor is a bit flirtatious, hopeful, and sensitive.
For help. Maybe the cops, someone like that.
Compliant.
I already tried once, but I'm on it.
And the traits can be viewed in the collection screen as well. So this is... okay. So we're kind of deciding what kind of person she is. The dismissive and the witty is disappearing in the background, whereas the flirtatious, hopeful, and sensitive is coming forth.
Hey, Andrew, buddy. How you doing?
Where are we? What happened?
Yeah, the bus crashed. We're okay, though. Just shaken up.
If you say so. I don't remember being in any crash.
You're probably in shock. Maybe a mild concussion in there, too. Give yourself some time. Stay here. Don't move.
Fucking thing, useless piece of crap! We'll be dead.
Okay, take it easy. We'll figure out what to do.
Daniel, who's a 20-year-old college student.
Fuck. Where's my phone?
Angela, who's 48, a mature student. Who's both abrasive and understanding.
Hey, okay. Anyone up there?
Hey, Daniel, that you?
John, good to hear you.
Daniel?
Taylor, you okay?
I'm good.
We're fine too, thanks for asking. You okay down there?
I'm all right, nothing I can't deal with.
Hey, John, any idea what caused the crash?
Not sure. Looked like the driver swerved to avoid something in the road. He down there, by the way?
Nope. No sign of him.
Weird. He isn't up here either. Can you get back up to us?
Looks pretty steep. I see a trail down here I could try.
Great. Take the trail. Should take you to the road. We can regroup there.
That's a plan. See you soon.
Hey, Taylor, help me get Andrew up on his feet, will ya?
Wait, I don't remember anything. Who are you?
It's okay. You're concussed. I'm John, you're a college professor. We were taking a bus on a field trip, but that didn't work out so well. Crash wasn't on the curriculum. We'll find the others, get some help. Think of it as a character building exercise.
Matching prompt.
Okay. Teamwork at its finest.
I had this dream. It was so real. Flames all around us. It was Grim.
That bang on the head must have been a beauty.
That trail the others are on will come out down the road. We'll meet them there.
Okay. Okay, let's be reluctant.
We should talk this through. Why leave the bus? Not like we have somewhere better to wait.
No. We could be here all night. Our best move is to get to the others, then head towards town. See if we can find some help.
Where's the bus
driver? Where's the driver? Shouldn't he be back by now?
The driver's done what we should be doing. Gone into town for help.
Hey, we got no reason not to be reassuring, right? We don't need to be aggressive about it right now. There's no point. It's not going to help anybody.
You're right. Let's go. I'm with you.
I'm right?
The quicker we get help, the quicker we can all go home.
Stick close behind me.
Baron's update. So Taylor agreed with John's plan to head into town. Team Taylor. Ah, you see the picture? I guess that's going to create, you know, a map of bearings to make. The little girl's down here. We went fine. That was something that we couldn't change, though, wasn't it? Right, so we've updated her traits as well. She's now sensitive. Aha. The deceitful's coming through. Okay. What happened with John? All of them were up arrows? Do we ever get down arrows? Do we know? Nothing with Angela. Nothing with Daniel. And nothing with Andrew, I don't think, right now. Follow John. Meet up with Angela and Daniel. Find the bus driver. Okay. So I think what we'll do is we'll stop there then. You've only made choices with your head where possible. That's interesting. We can't see anything else though. I would be interested to see anything else, but we can only be Taylor right now. All right. Well, we'll give this episode a close. We'll come back next time. See what happens further on down the road once we link up with everybody else. Wow. What a great first sort of introduction, so to speak. I genuinely thought that it was my fault that at least one person died, but I guess there was just no real chance that anyone was going to survive that fire, was there? Even the kid ran in at the end to just try and save everybody. What a hero. Sacrificed himself for dead people. But it's the way it goes, right? The next one will be out Wednesday. I hope you enjoyed it, guys. I had fun making it. I'm looking forward to doing more of these. Remember, if you want to see anything differently, please do leave me a comment down below. I will read it. I will respond. Or you can reach out to me. You can find me on Discord, Twitter, Instagram, or Twitch.